गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून। जस्ट गिव मी अ सेकंड एंड शेयर द लिंक टू एवरीबॉडी मे बी देयर। ओके सो वी वेयर हियर। बाय द टाइम अदर्स जॉइन जस्ट अप्लाई कपल ऑफ टेक्सचर्स। Later. So, like basic structure, you can see, like we were started creating all those small, small props and everything. Let's see what else we have. We have another bottle. Let's quickly create them without wasting any time. So this is like a small prop. If it's a detailed prop, I'll create the cap separate and body separate, but it's a small prop. So I'm just going to create this entire thing together. Oh, my bad. So like this, like we'll create all the bottles and everything one by one. And now I'll start with something bit well, other stuff. I can see there is a fridge, so let's start with this fridge. It's a broken fridge, so that means base body will be solid and doors will be separate. So this one box, duplicate. And you can see all the corners and everything is rounded. So fridge are usually like that. Perspective, and I like to work in perspective mode. I don't like orthographic at all. That gives you a distorted feel of everything. Front. So I can just simply hide this one. And because back main body is basically a rectangle with beveled corners and all. But I need that. I need to first fix the size. Create poly vertex mode, select all of the side vertices, create this. Base body is kind of straight, or it's rotated. It's in a slightly, you can say slightly angled, it's not like straight. So once we create the entire model, then we tilt it. We don't create a model in tilted manner because it will become difficult for us to manage. Like suppose I want to rotate something or do something, it will become very difficult. So we'll create everything in a straight and correct format and then rotate it. So structure is fine and all the corners are nicely beveled. So I'll select everything, all the edges. See, all the edges. I can chamfer it. Not too much, very little. There's a slight angle, and if you want to make this corners little nice and smoother, add two loops. Like instead of one, use two loops. It will give you nice smooth, you see, rounded angles. And I can use, let's see, there's a quad option, right? Yeah, I can use a quad option, so everything will be quad. But this problem with the quad is it makes everything a bit angular. So with this uniform, everything is nicely round and smooth. Done. Now hide all, unhide, sorry, unhide all. Select, oh, sorry, unhide all. Select this one. The polygons, edges. Select all of them. Apply the same chamfer. Right. That's strange. Should work without any problem. Like it should have repeated the old setting. Done. Front. Alt X, transparent. Just like you look like as of now, only focus on one angle, one side, only the like thickness and size. Shift duplicate. It's a double door fridge. Same. So both the sides are ready. And now what I'll do is now I'll tilt the main fridge plus everything. So select all three of them and tilt it slightly front so you can see. Now select one at a time and that angle, fix it. Slightly open, slightly open, and make sure there is no intersection. All three of them, a gap. Select one, attach, attach, attach. Done. Move it, and it's between these two frames, between this frame, this third last window front. somewhere here. Should not intersect with this. Now, let's see, we have a crate here. So this is like, you can see we can create this thing. Let's create this one front. Okay, let's create something big. Like, you can see these cartons are repeating a lot. So let's create one carton and then repeat it. That will be like, it will fill up my entire scene and it'll give me this 10% of work will be done. So I'll just focus on this. So before that, I need to create this frame so that I can place it everywhere. You can see this this crate I can repeat here. This carton I can repeat here, 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 here. There's so many places carton is repeating. So just a it's basically a box. Too much front. Let's create only one at a time. Like modeling is like, it's all about like patience. You need to have patience and then create everything slowly. Slightly less white. Now this part I need to delete. Reason, the box, the carton is open and the side, these two sides, you can see, I can see the angle clearly, and scale it. Oh, first I need to fix the pivot point center. Won't work. Okay. I'm keeping it little random, so it doesn't look like a symmetrical from both the side. Slightly uneven, and you can see the corners is little rounded, and plus the their thickness, because it's a carton, this box, this what do you call it, this cardboard box, so it's little thick. So you have to add a shell. Outside nothing, inner little thickness. And if I want, I can bevel. Oh, there is no bevel. Like there's no this thing, spline to bevel it. Segments, if I want, I can definitely add, but that is something is not required. Because just a basic, basic simple carton box. Let's keep it simple only. Front. So let's see. Let's create the placement. See. And apply edit poly one more. So done, then duplicate the same box. No, it's like this only, but only difference is this front panel is not there. Box, and you can see box is slightly angled, so rotate slightly, apply a shell, or what I can do is it's like, okay, it's apply the same shell, it's nice, but now I have to check the placement. It cannot intersect each other, so well, it's in front basically, so it should come here somewhere. Front, select this one, duplicate it again. There is a cylinder also, I can see clearly. This side is not visible, so I'm keeping it simple. Now I have here 1, 2, 3 boxes. Those are kind of closed. They're basically literally boxes. There's nothing, it's just box. So I can duplicate it here. Delete. Select this one, cap it. Just box, closed box. It's slightly rotated. So before rotating, I'll just duplicate this. And again, duplicate it here. Now I'll select this one, rotate it slightly. Now it's intersecting, so it cannot be placed here. It should be somewhere here, backside. You can see clearly it's like behind this box, and this carter can be slightly moved back. So I have nice dimensions, variations and all. Cartons are, most of the cartons are ready. So slightly rotated in this angle, and plus this one have little extrusion here, so I'll apply edit poly. Select this one and use extrude it slightly. That angle, create that angle. So this box is also ready. Now you can see there is one more carton here. So for this open carton, I can use this one. So like you have to identify all these repetitive things, because there's no point creating the same thing again and again and again, right? So like you can save a lot of time, or you already have a base model or basic structure ready, use it again and modify it. That will be like way easier. And 2020, but I don't have a license. I have only 2020. So like you can register yourself by with the AID ID.
ID, you don't have it.
Oh, you don't have it. Okay. Okay, I'll see. Like, if, or you can download it from any torrent site, that's also fine. Like it's
not that. I have a version.
Your voice is cracking. I'm not able to understand anything.
You can hear me, sir?
Yes, now it's clear.
Like my Photoshop Autodesk printed went in some error. I don't know what happened. So I have to reset my PC, whole PC. I lost all my files, my applications and all. So
how?
I called D drive. I called Venkatesh sir, and he told that need to install the maybe crack, and told him that the crack went in some power also. So
No, what I'm saying ki you don't you see don't save anything into D drive. You save everything to C drive.
C drive. I install on C drive only.
No, files. How you lost your files? That's what I'm asking.
Files, I don't know. May I didn't so some something made some problem. I don't know what happened.
Usually, like whatever you save in C drive, your system crashes, that part only goes. So, make sure you save everything into D drive. Do not save anything into C drive or desktop or My Documents. It's all C drive.
I save only in D drive only, sir. So C drive not saving nothing.
Then, how you lost your file?
I didn't lost any files, but
Oh, okay. I
I have
heard like
to.
you lost file. Okay.
Yeah, I lost files because the PC may went into some problem. So I have to reset the PC. So I lost all the files. But when I reinstalled the Autodesk 2020 version, it was not coming. Like, was not downloading us or I don't know what happened.
So maybe some technical issue from of your
Yeah, so I called Vengesh sir, so he told that there is this you use the trial version or get the student's version. So I'm right now I'm using the trial version,
Okay.
like for 1 month I think.
Okay.
So he'll be helping me with the crack or something, I don't know.
Oh, that's fine. So all boxes are ready, everything is ready. I can see one.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Yes.
Sir, for the 2020 version of Autodesk 3ds Max, sir, it's written 3 years of term. So
Yes.
after 3 years, we can't use it, sir.
No, like for students, you can use whatever you want to use. Nobody cares. Nobody will come and
Okay.
sue you. Huh? Don't worry about that. I don't
Okay.
know. I have.
For that, we need to go to college, right? We need to come there, right? For the ID card. We need ID card, I think.
No, I gave 2020 license key and all, right?
Yeah, I got that, but it won't work in 2021, right?
It won't work 2020. It's 2020 license, huh?
Yeah, 2020 also it won't work in my computer. So
sir, and after that, so like when we turn on the software, so internet is not required, right? Like
Not at
without the
all.
internet.
Not at
Okay.
all. Internet is not required. Yes, if you have internet, it will give you updates and everything.
Okay.
Give you updates and everything, but that's it. So no need
So
to
do
worry.
we need to update
Yes, it's licensed version. So you can, if you want, you can definitely update it.
Okay, sir.
Okay, what happened here? Oh, it's wrong direction. Why this angle? Okay, like a lot of cartons I have created. So let's hide this one, hide selection, select everything together, move it somewhere here only. So a slightly placement issue I can see. Yeah. Somewhere here. I can push it back. Yes. So now I have to check everything and identify their placement.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, I'm not able to find that mega scans that thing in. I think the mixer. I think in Autodesk.
Setting? What setting? I didn't understand. Hello.
Yes, sir.
What you're saying, I didn't understand. Like, can you? Like,
sir, that? I'm not getting that that mixer thing, sir, in the Photoshop.
Mixture? What mixture in Photoshop? You don't. What mixture?
Oh, I mean the mega scans thing. Yeah.
So you don't need mixture.
So for testers thing, what we are doing, like
bridge, Quixel bridge.
Bridge for the bridge thing. I'm not finding that option in Autodesk.
Why? It's not Autodesk. I'm. You pay attention first. What I'm saying, it's Quixel. It's not Autodesk. It's a different software altogether. It's a different software. You have to go to Quixel.com. From there, you have to download Quixel Bridge. Just give me a second. I'll open and show it.
I have downloaded that thing.
Then install it.
I installed that. And then how do we link that thing?
Link what you have to link. Can you explain like what you are saying? I'm not able to understand. Like, can you explain that? Like, what you are asking? I'm not able to understand your question. Like, you are trying to connect it with Autodesk or something?
Yes, sir. Like, is there any link to that? How do we link that into 3ds Max? Like,
okay, you are saying you are trying to
link the bridge to 3ds Max.
You want to install a bridge for 3ds Max. That's what you mean, right?
I have installed bridge. Installment. Then.
Yes. Then I'm showing you. Just give me a second. You don't have to link anything, do anything. You just have, you log in with Epic, right? In Quixel.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, done. So after that, so you don't have to like, you just simply click on anything. Let's see. Any of the material textures available in this. Let's see. I have a lot of, select that. So you can just right click, go to file. You can see there is a text, there is your texture. So you don't have, like, technically don't have to link anything to anywhere. Now you have to drag drop that texture there. Like, what I'm showing, I never showed anything to link or anything. Like, from where it's coming, I don't have any clue. So right click, open the file. It will open the folder where all the texture, just simply click this texture, drag drop into your Max. Like, suppose I want to apply this texture to this plank, right? So what I'll do, I'll select this texture, click, drag and drop. Done. That's it.
Okay.
But like what you ask, it's like we can definitely do it. Like if you want, we can definitely install a plugin. Go to setting, you can see this corner, setting, download setting, you can go, so no, sorry, no download setting. For export and all, you have to go to export setting. So by default in my system, I have installed Unreal because we are going to use Unreal for most of the, because in game, we use everything for engine. It's not for production. So we use everything for Unreal. So that's why I installed it. But if you want to install this for 3ds Max, you can click this. You can see there is an option for 3ds Max as well. Click on this. It's already installed. It says, so it's all like you can from it. It will ask for the path or something. It will ask for install. You just click and install it. That's it. But it's not required. It's not mandatory. You can just simply drag, drop it. It will work perfectly without any problem.
Okay, sir. Sir, we are learning Unreal Engine, right?
You will learn later. Like, that's like after quite after like still you have time, like 6, 7, 8 months time. After that, you'll learn. Yes, you have. After that, you'll learn. And till date, I haven't seen anything like proper corrected things from you. Like you, whatever you showed, like I gave you so many corrections. I haven't seen any update on that.
Sir, like I'm just sharing you within this evening, sir.
Okay, no problem. Like whenever you finish it, send me, because until unless see the file, I cannot correct you, because this is what we are doing right now. It's basics. So it's like you need to fix it and understand everything and basically correct everything. So need to, it's all about understanding. If you understand, like everything is fine. So like that understanding you need to develop. So like whatever you're creating, you can create extra stuff, you can do things and send back to me and I'll check it. I'll give you feedback on that. And if it's correct, I'll say it correct. If it's like you need to fix something, I'll explain how to fix it and everything. So practice, it's all about practice. Okay. So things are ready. Placement. And
sir, I have the doubts regarding the knowledge project. So if you have any time, you would be free to get doubts cleared.
Like what doubts about what?
Like on the earlier projects you were done, right?
So we have doubt Saturday, we have doubt clearing sessions, right?
Okay, then we can do that.
Okay, my boxes are, you can see, almost set. I set in the scene. This is set on the scene and I can see there's an issue. It's intersecting the high selection, this box. It's there, but there's an issue. So always cross-check everything. That means either my placement is wrong or something, my size scale is wrong. Double-check everything and fit it nicely. And it was underground. So because thing is, like, why all this thing happens? Because we test it out from this image, right? But still there is a placement issue. Reason, this image is in perspective. When we're creating in front view, it's an orthographic view. It's not perspective. So placement issue, you can see there is slanting, like it's going up, right? That perspective, your 2-point perspective is there. So, but in front view, there is no perspective. That's why that those issue happens. So you have to manually tweak again and fix it and place them nicely. Okay. Now we have to create this rack. So it's front view. So easiest way of creating this, I can extrude it from a box also. Or I can see it's a round circular shape. So what I'll prefer is I'll prefer to create this thing with the help of a line. And base I'm keeping it straight, and I feel this line is not 100% straight, this one, so I'll make it straight. So once I create this shape, I'll make sure this is perfectly straight line. Maybe you can use segments, and yeah, see, segment wise I can make it perfectly straight. This also I can make it perfectly straight. These shapes should be straight only. Now go to rendering, enable in viewport and this thing, and thickness reduce it. Thickness, so you can see basic structure is ready really quickly and easily, and it have, like, you can see one side and another side. So that means I need to create three of them. My pad, cancel, go to angle, snap on, shift and drag 90 degrees. Uh, and shift and drag this side also. Now go to perspective, see, select these two, place it here, and it kind of feels way too wide. So I'll just place this thing first in my scene, then I'll check. But before that, I'll create this basic. You can see there's one more frame here. So that frame is not visible. Is it solid or just a pipe or something? Not visible. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a plane there, like box there. Top view. Box. Front Z, and I feel it's pretty thick. Thickness is too much. Reduce thickness. So here also you can see base, there is something, and plus I can see there is rulers. That is also have to create. So before that, I'll just simply select this entire scene and this section, and then let's attach it. Edit poly, attach. Right click, and let's place it in my scene, and let's check the thickness and width and everything. Is it proper or not? It's somewhere here, and we go backside, but not inside the wall. That is something to keep in mind. Yeah. I can place it here nicely, and I feel, see, this is slightly intersecting with the door. So what I have to do is I have to make it little less wider, reduce the width slightly, push it back. I can push it like quite like this, but it looks like this only. So whenever you have a reference from one side, you don't have like reference from multiple angles, you have to use your own imagination and modify things accordingly, because like there will be cases where you don't have enough references. So either you can Google out those references, like some reference, some few more references, and check things, and then create it. Okay, let me see this thing. See, so you can see I have created curtains and everything, boxes. Let's see what else we have here. Oh, there is a chair, and there is this thing is also there, and plus some garbage bags. So this, let's create this garbage bag, because it's I can see 1, 2, 3, so it will populate my scene also. Let's create only one garbage bag. I'll take a box. So you can see most of the things I'm using a box. This is called box modeling. So I'm using a box, and using this box, I'm creating everything. So I can sides, I can define. All the sides, if I want, I can define, but I feel it's too much. Let's have one of this thing that will be easy for me to manage. Edit poly. Uniformly scale down. uniformly scale down from all the sides. Initially, I'll do that, then I'll start manipulating things individually. Placement, sorry, rotation of slight rotation scale. You can see it's not matching with the shape, so you need to have one more cut here. Either I can select all, use a connect, then I can move them nicely. Here also I need one more cut, or I can use swift loop, add a loop. Like both are absolutely fine. You can use any one of them. Basic structure, and check it. It look should look like round from both the angles. Now, it should be round. It's not round yet, so make it slightly rounded. Slightly rounded, and extrude. Extrude. Rotate slightly. My bad. Select this one also. Rotate it slightly. Like angles are very important, so correct them. So once you create this, it's a very low poly model. So initially, whenever you're creating anything, make sure it's a really, really low poly model. Then apply. Just match the basic structure. You can see I applied a turbo smooth. Instantly, it looks like a bag sack kind of thing. So then later, what I can do is it's increase the poly count. Now, if I want something to modify, like to create those angles and everything, it's also uneven. So what I'll do, I'll apply one more 8 poly and select my shape, alt X, call this shape. And here is something you can see called soft selection. Switch it on, click any of the vertex, edge, face, it works on everything. Reduce, increase or reduce the fall off means you can see that this green yellow line, that means still there it will affect. So see, it will affect like this. So I don't want to affect this entire thing like this, so I'll just go back to turbo, increase slightly, go back to my vertex again, reduce the fall off, and I want to create those unevenness. Was garbage bag, it's full of trash, so it cannot be straight and so clean and smooth. It will be uneven from every angle. I'm creating all those folds and twists and everything. Oh, my bad. This black is basically outline. You can see it creates, you can create like this, nice folds and everything. So because one side is visible, other side is not visible. So what I can do is I can just simply keep, like check this, and based on our like one side reference, I can modify other sides also. So it's a trash bag, so it cannot be like really smooth and soft from all any side. All the sides will be uneven. Mistakenly move the You can see it start looking like you have folds and all unevenness. But this is like way too high poly for this. So like just to show you, I applied this turbo. It's not required, but still you can see. You can see all those folds, unevenness on the surface. We'll keep that. Oh, sorry. Isolate. Now we have three of them. Duplicate and move here. So one by one, now you can use same soft selection. I'll use the same soft selection and modify things. I'll decrease the fall off. Reduce it again. Uneven. Now this one. So okay, I just created one and then modified it. So it have now we have three variations. Key bags next to this, select one, attach. front perspective, zoom out, and just to like make sure everything is on ground, I can switch on. You can see it's on the air somewhere here. So you can see like everything is coming together slowly. Yeah, this structure, this thing. There's one more cartoon I can see. I missed it. I create this also. There is a wooden some stand kind of thing is there. And a couple of planks. There's a trash can. So let's create this. It's again same thing. Box. So most of the things you can see is clearly it's box only. We start with box. Polygons. Oh, those in between lines I don't want. Not required. Not required. It's a bit slightly tapered at the base. Swift loop. Add this loop. Extrude. By normal direction. In top of it, there is a cover. And the front part is, I believe, slightly going inside. Edge mode, target weld. This part is same. Slightly going inside. And length also it reduced slightly to get it proper shape. Otherwise, it will create problem. And all these edges, I can make it slightly beveled, slightly chamfered. It will be rounded nicely. And this bend, I can create very easily with the help of this thickness. And one more, and reduce. It should be slightly rounded. You can see there's a gap. Like maybe to hold that section. It's because really low poly. So initially, whenever you create anything, keep it as low as possible. Do not increase poly count unnecessarily until and unless it's really required. And this part going inside. But this depth I have to create corners are round. Make it slightly bevel, and we'll create this, this, and everything. See. Somewhere here. You can see slowly everything is coming together. I'm adding all details, small props. Now we have like, still we have a lot of props, lot of things to do. You can see we have a little bit of this pot, there's a dish, there's an AC hydrant, there's a pipe, another trash bag, then there's a dustbin, there's like some stopper or something. Then this plank stand, there's another two more boxes, there is a broom, two more planks, there's a railing, there's a metal trash, this thing, dustbin. So create all these things, we'll create. And this lamppost also, this wire and all, we have to create. Yeah, we'll create all of them. So like this, you can see it's not difficult. It's just like about like sitting and doing it, like spending some time and like slowly and doing everything. It's all about, it's all about like sit and like, with some patience, you have to do and deliver everything. Okay, I have another class now, so I'll take it in this quickly. And tomorrow, tomorrow it's like if I schedule a meeting in the morning time, that's fine, I believe.
Yes, sir.
Like morning around 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock, so we can like easily finish it off, because I have another class also, so it will be easy for everybody. You can practice after that.
So the new link which you sent on WhatsApp, so with that link, sir?
With same link.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I'll send you the time also in group. I update that, and then we'll do it. Let's see. Arnold is absent. Akshay is here. Ashwin, Deepas, and this guy is absent. Okay, then I'll see you guys tomorrow. I'll update a timing, and then we'll and whatever you have doubts, you can keep everything ready. Tomorrow we'll discuss everything based on your file and your issues. Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay then. Bye-bye.